today we are here in this video to discuss about the new measures which have been introduced by the Canadian government, by IRCC. Basically, why have been introduced? The motive is to, you know, reduce the number of temporary residents currently present inside Canada. Specifically, you know, they have targeted international students and the foreign workers. So on September 18, this changing news have come basically. So Honorable Mark Miller, who is the Minister of Immigration, Refugee and Citizenship, he has announced several impactful measures basically. So yes, let's dive into each of the new policies which have been introduced. So first is basically the reduction of study permits for 2025. So yes, in 2024, no other impact, but yes, from 2025, they will be reducing the number of study permits that has to be issued. So this is one of the most significant change, I would say, regarding the intake of international students. So starting in 2025, basically what they will be doing is they will be reducing the study permits targets by 10% from 2024. In 2024, their target was 485,000 study permits that they have to issue. But now they are thinking to decline this number by 10%. So in 2025, their new target is 437,000. So this is the number of students that they are planning they will intake in the year 2025. And this cap, the 2026 year also, the cap will remain same, which is 437,000 students. So yes, not many more international students they are going to take because there is a set cap now. So second policy which they have bring out, the second change they have bring out, is impacting the, you know, international students who are already studying inside Canada. So yes, they have bring changes to the postgraduate work permit program. So starting in November 2024, new language requirements will be introduced for the PGWP applicants. So basically, university graduates, if you are graduating from a university, you will need to meet a benchmark of CLB 7, and if you are graduating from college, that is college graduates, they will need a CLB 5. So why they are introducing this? Because as per them, this will ensure, you know, that the international students, they are better equipped to integrate into the Canadian workforce. So yes, another change to the postgraduate work permit program only. So let's dive into the third policy, third change they have bring into. Third major change that they are, you know, bringing into the PGW program is about the issuing of the postgraduate work permit. So earlier, you know, when students who used to do the 2-year course, they used to get a 3-year work permit. They were eligible for up to 3-year work permit, but now they are changing this. Now the issuance of the 3-year work permit will be linked to the occupation basically and their field of study. So it will be limited to graduates from fields of study. So only if you are studying in particular fields that are linked to the occupations which are in shortage in Canada. So if you have studied such courses related to which the occupation is in shortage in Canada, then only you will be eligible for an up to 3 years work permit. So yes, there is no surety that you will get a postgraduate work permit after doing studies from Canada. So yes, this is also a major change that they are bringing into the postgraduate work permit, thereby you know, achieving their motive, their target of reducing the number of temporary residents inside Canada. So yes, now talking about the fourth policy, fourth major change that they have announced, which is now the work permit eligibility for the spouses of foreign students and the workers both. At the end of 24, spouses of, you know, only those students who are pursuing a master's degree inside Canada, and that too a master's degree of at least 16 months, only they will be eligible to apply for the spousal open work permit, not others. And now talking about, we talked about the students front, now talking about the workers front. Whether you are working in Canada on an LMIA or maybe on a postgraduate work permit, but now your spouse will be eligible for a work permit depending upon your occupation, what kind of occupation you are doing. So if you are doing any management occupation or any professional occupation or any industries which are facing labor shortages, in that situation only your spouse will be eligible for a work permit. So earlier there was no such restriction, whether you were working in any kind of occupation, just be on a postgraduate work permit or an LMIA, then your spouses were eligible to apply for a work permit. But now the situation is changing. Only specific occupations, then only your spouses can apply for the work permit. Yes, these are some of the, you know, major I would say measures which have been introduced by the Canadian government. So targeting basically international students, foreign workers and also their spouses. So what government is trying to do is, you know, making some adjustments to sustain its immigration programs, and they are now prioritizing Canadian workers instead of the foreign workers, and also addressing the critical labor shortages in Canada. So if you are planning to study, work or bring your family to Canada, then these changes could impact your plans. So before deciding on what course to study, what job or occupation to take up, it's definitely necessary that, you know, if you really want to bring into your family, then only take up occupations or courses which are, you know, related to those fields in which there is critical shortages in Canada. So yes, if you found this video helpful, don't forget to like, subscribe and share. For more updates on Canadian immigration news, stay tuned to our channel, Sans Global Immigration.